The mitosis cell division, it is also called equational cell division, because suppose we have any cell and that cell have suppose 46 chromosome. We are talking about a simple human cell. Okay, suppose a human cell have 46 chromosome, and when this cell divides, okay, and after the cell division, the new formed cell, they also contain 46 chromosome and 46 chromosome. It means the newly formed cell, that is also called daughter cell, they contains equal number of chromosome to the original cell, that is called mother cell. If the daughter cell contains equal number of chromosome to the mother cell, that type of cell division is called equational cell division, and mitosis cell division is also the equational cell division. It means mother cell and daughter cell chromosomes are equal. Similarly, mitosis cell division occurs in the somatic cell. In our human body, there are two types of cell, reproductive cell and somatic cell. If we are saying the cells of testis and ovary, they are called reproductive cell. But other cells of our body, they are called somatic cell, because their main function is growth and development. So mitosis cell division occurs in the somatic cell. Okay, similarly, when you talk about the mitosis cell division whole process, the whole process are divided into two group, that is karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis means division of nucleus. You can say karyokinesis means nuclear division. Nuclear division. Plus cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. cytoplasmic division, we can say cytoplasmic division. So when the mitosis cell division takes place, first karyokinesis takes place. It means first nucleus is divided, then cytoplasmic materials are divided. We can say like this. Suppose this is any cell, it has a nucleus. First, the nucleus division takes place. This nuclear material get divided. Now, then after the cytokinesis takes place. Okay. This is nuclear division, or simply you can say this is karyokinesis process. Then after the karyokinesis has taken place, nucleus has been divided, then the cytoplasmic material get divided and the cell change into single cell change into two cells, and this is called cytokinesis. So karyokinesis plus cytokinesis, when it occurs, then we can say total mitosis cell division has occurred. This mitosis cell division, one mother cell, original cell is known as mother cell. One mother cell produces two daughter cell, and they contains equal number of chromosome to that of mother cell. If a mother cell contains 46 chromosome, the daughter cell has also 46 chromosome. Okay. Now let us talk about this karyokinesis. The karyokinesis, that is also called the nucleus division, that occurs in four stages. Okay, there are four types of changes occur in the process of karyokinesis. These four stages are prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. We can also remember this like PAMAT. First letter of each stage, we can say prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. First letter PMAT, PAMAT, we can remember mitosis. Now let us talk about these all the stages. The prophase, the first stage of karyokinesis. In this stage, what happens? We know that in the cell there is nucleus, and inside the nucleus there is DNA. This DNA is called chromatin. This is called chromatin. Why it is called chromatin? Because this DNA is actually, suppose this is the DNA thread, and it is wrapped around the protein. This is the protein. Okay, lot of proteins are there, and this DNA thread is wrapped around that protein. This protein is called histone protein. then when DNA is wrapped around the protein, that is called, actually this is called chromatin. Okay, then inside the nucleus, the DNA is present in the form of chromatin. Okay, actually this DNA, when you see, it is a double-stranded structure. You might have studied about it. Then inside this nucleus, the DNA is present in the form of chromatin. And when this cell is ready to go for a cell division, before the cell go for a cell division, it has some stage that is called interphase stage. In that interphase stage, the DNA whatever present, that has got duplicated before the cell division. And that chromatin is, but that chromatin is highly coiled in a thread like structure. In this, when this cell go for a cell division, in this first stage, that is also called prophase stage, this highly coiled chromatin slowly starts to condense. That this is, suppose this is a chromatin, when it starts to condense, then it starts to take the form of chromosomes. This like structure is starts to form. Okay, another event that takes place here, that is this nuclear membrane starts to disappear. This nuclear membrane starts to disappear. Similarly, the nucleolus is present in this nucleus. This nucleolus also starts to disappear in this stage. Another event, in this cell, in the cytoplasm, there is some structure like this, that is called centriole. If it is in, especially in animal cell, they are present. The centriole starts to move towards the opposite poles. This centriole move towards the opposite pole. So suppose centriole has come here and centriole has come here. This centriole is responsible to form some thread-like structure. It is responsible to form a thread-like structure from here. That thread-like structure, whatever they are forming, that is called spindle fiber. This much event takes place in the prophase. Now let us conclude the prophase. We saw that the chromatin starts to condense. It means chromosome appears. Similarly, nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to disappear. Centriole move towards the opposite pole. Spindle fiber starts to appear. These are the 4 points that we need to remember in prophase. Now let us know about the metaphase. We know that chromosome structure starts to appear in the prophase by the condensation of the chromatin fiber. In this metaphase stage, the complete condensation of chromosome has occurred. It means we can see a clear chromosome structure in this stage. The nuclear membrane and the nucleolus, which was starting to disappear in the prophase stage, in this metaphase stage, this completely get disappear. It means the chromosome is directly appearing in the cytoplasm, we can say. The chromosome directly appear in the cytoplasm. Next thing, suppose we are talking about a human cell, then how many chromosomes will be formed inside our cell? There are 46 chromosomes. And that all the 46 chromosomes will be arranged in the equatorial plane of this cell. Actually, this cell is a spherical structure. Then inside our cell, all the chromosomes will be arranged in the equatorial plane, equator. Okay, all the cell will be arranged in the equator like this. okay, 46 chromosome will arrange in the equatorial plane of the cell. Next event that takes place here, from this centriole, we are saying what was forming in the prophase? Spindle fiber. That spindle fiber totally get formed and attached to the centromere of the chromosome. We know that this structure is called centromere, and to this centromere spindle fiber attached from the both end of the pole. Similarly, on this chromosome also spindle fiber from here and from here get attached like this. Then how many chromosomes are there? All are arranged in the equator, and from both end spindle fiber comes and attached to the centromere of each chromosome. In this metaphagic stage, we can see complete structure of the chromosome. This is called one chromatid, this much structure is called one chromatid, and this much structure is called another chromatid. Okay, this chromatid and this chromatid, they are held by the help of this structure that is called centromere, and this chromatid is exact photocopy of this chromatid. They are also called sister chromatid. Okay, this side chromatid and this side chromatid, they contains exactly 100% similar gene. They are called sister chromatid. Now let us conclude the metaphase. In this metaphase stage, nucleolus and nuclear membrane completely disappears. In prophase, it was starting to disappear, but in this metaphase stage, that has completely disappeared. And complete condensation of chromosome has taken place. The chromosome in prophase, it was condensing into the chromatin was condensing into the chromosome, but complete condensation has not occurred in the prophase. But now in the metaphase, complete condensation of chromosome has taken place. This is the best stage to see the complete structure of chromosome. And at this time, chromosome is present in cytoplasm because nuclear membrane is disappeared, and the chromosome get arranged around the equator in a plane around equator, and spindle fiber from both end, from the centriole spindle fiber is coming, that has attached to the centromere of each chromosome. From the both end, spindle fiber are coming and getting attached to the centromere of each chromosome. Let us talk about the anaphase stage. We know that in the metaphase, the cells are arranged in the, we know that in the metaphase stage, all the chromosomes are arranged in the equator, and spindle fiber from both end has attached there. We know that in the metaphase stage, the spindle fiber has attached to the centromere, and all the chromosomes are arranged in the equatorial plane of the cell. Now, in this anaphase stage, what happens? This chromosome, we know that this is one sister chromatid, this is another sister chromatid. This is sister chromatid, one sister chromatid, this is another sister chromatid. Now, this chromosome from here splits from here at this place. Now the chromosome splits simultaneously. All the chromosome splits simultaneously. Okay. So in the anaphase stage, the chromosome splits like this. At the anaphase, the chromosome splits and one chromatid move up, another chromatid starts to move down. Now this chromatid is called chromosome. When the chromatid get splitted, it is called chromosome. This chromosome move up and this chromosome move down. This spindle fiber starts to contract and they take this chromosome towards the opposite pole. So suppose here is two chromosome, then two chromosome are moving this side after splitting and two chromosome is moving downside. Equally, the chromosomes are moving towards the opposite pole. And when this chromosome is pulled by this spindle fiber, then this chromosome are seen in different structure. There is, suppose there is centromere, when this centromere is pulled, then this chromosome appears in different shape. Let us see what are the shape that can be seen. It is, if the chromosome is metacentric, we know that chromosomes are of different type on the basis of position of centromere. If the chromosome is metacentric, it means the centromere is exactly present at the middle. Then when this is pulled, then it appears the shape like this. It is seen like this structure. We can say like this structure or inverted V-shape structures is seen. If it is submetacentric chromosome, it means the chromosome submetacentric chromosome, it means the centromere is present slightly away from the middle. When it is pulled, when this is pulled, then it appears like this structure. It is slightly L shape structure, inverted L shape structure. Similarly, suppose it is acrocentric chromosome, it means centromere is slightly present nearby the end. Suppose like this chromosome it is, then when it is pulled, then it appears like this structure. It means a slightly inverted J-shape structure is seen. Similarly, if it is telocentric chromosome, then we know that in telocentric, the centromere is exactly present at the end. Then when it is pulled, it takes the form like this, like I form. Different shape of chromosome can be appeared in the anaphase stage. Now let us conclude anaphase. In anaphase, each chromosome splits simultaneously, and now each chromatid of the chromosome is called chromosome. That splitted chromatid, they are called now chromosome. Similarly, chromosome move towards the opposite pole, forming various shape. By different shape, they are going towards the opposite pole. What happens in the telophase? In the anaphase, when the chromosome is moving, in the telophase, what happens? In the anaphase, the chromosome starts to move towards the opposite pole, that is splits. Now in the telophase, this chromosome goes to the opposite pole. All the chromosome goes to the opposite pole here. In the telophase stage, after the splitting of chromosome in the anaphase, that chromosome starts to move towards the opposite pole, then in the telophase stage, the chromosome reaches to the opposite pole. After it reaches to the opposite pole, now this starts to change into the thread-like structure. It means this chromosome gets changed into the thread-like chromatin fiber, we can say. This chromosome change into the, starts to decondense and change into the chromatin fiber. And nuclear membrane starts to appear. Similarly, nucleolus also starts to appear in the both end of the cell. And this spinal fiber that completely get disappear in the telophase stage. At the end of telophase stage, now complete nuclear membrane are seen here. Complete nucleolus is seen inside this. And the now we can say complete nucleus has formed here. From one nucleus, now two nucleus is formed. Nucleus has been divided. It means now karyokinesis is complete. Now let us conclude the telophase. In the telophase, chromosome reach to their respective poles and starts to decondense into chromatin. It means at this place chromosome now change into the chromatin by the decondense. Again thread like structures are seen. Chromosomes are not seen. Chromosome structures are lost now. They change into chromatin fiber. Spindle fiber disappears. That is spindle fiber now disappears. And nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to appear in the both side of the chromosome. At both poles, nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to appear. Now let us talk after the karyokinesis. Now cytokinesis takes place. That is the division of cytoplasm. All the materials of the cytoplasm are equally divided into two part of the cell. Let us know how the cytokinesis takes place. In the plant cell and animal cell, they occur in different way. If it is a plant cell, after the karyokinesis, some chemical starts to get deposited in the middle of the cell. In the plant cell, the chemical is calcium pectate. And after the deposition of the chemical, one cell plate is formed there. Okay, after the formation of plate, now this cell get divided. In this way, cytokinesis takes place in the plant cell. But in animal cell, this is also called cell plate method. The cytokinesis occur in plant cell by cell plate method. But in animal cell, after the karyokinesis, the cell membrane invaginate, that constrict, and after the constrict, they get finally break down into two cell. And this method is also called furrowing method or constriction method, that occurs in this way cytokinesis occurred in the animal cell. And after the cytokinesis, finally from one cell two cells are formed. In this way, the complete mitosis cell division occurs in plant and animal. And this mitosis cell division has different importance. They help in the growth and development of the organism. They help in the repairing the old tissue, damaged tissue are repaired by the help of mitosis cell. Hope you understood the mitosis cell division. But still, if you have any problem, please comment. I'll try to make your concept clear. Thank you very much. Please subscribe my channel, like my video, share my video. Thank you very much. Best of luck.